Hello my fellow gearheads and mainly space lovers. Today I would like to show you the M-tronified version of the Interstellar Spaceship 60430, which received quite a lot of attention on my Instagram and Facebook posts. As a source of main inspiration, I used the very first LEGO set that I ever owned, which is the 6877 Vector Detector from the M-tron product line that I was given as already quite an old kid, being 11 years old. I just would like to encourage you to do your own build or update of any of the sets that you like into the themes that you like, and trust me, it's not that difficult. Just look at the catalogs or the sets you own at home and take a look at the main icons. So here in this case it's the Trans Neon Green Cockpit, the two antenna whips over here, some of the Trans Neon Green small radar dishes and the green cones. There is a tiny magnetic holder for the container over here, and as well these classic gray space engines. And besides that, what is a key feature as well of the Vector Detector for me are those two vertical stabilizers. So simply, I built the Interstellar spaceship again and started ripping off the white parts and the parts in the colors that were not available yet back then in 1990. Of course, I swapped the old light gray for the new version of the light bluish gray, but most of the things are the stuff that I had lying around or attached to other M-tron sets that I borrowed these pieces from. First of all, the main color scheme of the M-tron uses the red, black. Some of the sets utilize as well a little bit of light gray, and afterwards the trans neon green is really important highlight color for this. So for the vertical stabilizers, I used a newer, more modern looking element, because why not? And it shouldn't stop you as well from using whatever else you have at home. Then I used as well some of the small gray engines. As I said, the small cones are kind of key, and instead of using the radar dishes at the front, I decided to go as well for the cones. And the radar dishes get afterwards repeated three times on the bodywork, one as the activation button for spreading the nozzle, so you can afterwards just press it over here, and the other two on the side of the wings. And then besides, you just need some M-tron tiles, an M-tron minifigure, another M-tron piece, which is not too difficult to use as well, is the same one as the Vector Detector uses, as you can see on the front. So I just hid it underneath the cockpit, and that's pretty much it. So just use your fantasy, use whatever you have available, and afterwards something like this will be the end results. I as well used the trans neon green over here around the nozzle, and even though it makes a little sense because this would get burned by the engine, I don't care. You know, there's nothing to stop you from doing whatever you feel like, because I think this working as a crane is really fun. And yeah, instead of placing the antenna whips vertically, I placed them at an angle on the hinges over here. The end position is afterwards defined by the piece sitting in front of it, and that's pretty much it. So what you get afterwards brings as well a lot of fun and nostalgia, and as well is reminiscent of the set that you wanted to use as a source inspiration, even though not being exactly the same, obviously, because you're building it on a completely different platform, using as well a lot more modern pieces in many cases. But yeah, as I said, it's a lot of fun. If you have a favorite theme and would like to change the Interstellar spaceship into something else, then just go for it. You don't need that many parts, and if you don't have them, you can always source them from other servers like Bricklink, etc. And that's all from my side. Until next time, everybody, stay safe, take care, bye bye, and enjoy.